Hey yo， 我是 Parker， 欢迎回到帕克英文，又来到每周两次的多益必考单字时间啦。这期影片呢，依照惯例要在我们开始复习单字之前，给同学们一个文法的测验题。进画面。如果需要时间观看题目的话，可以先将影片暂停，或者我等你三秒钟的时间。三、二、一，准备好了吗？好，那在我们公布答案之前呢，也就进行到今天30个以 agriculture 农业为主题相关的多益必考单字。答案呢会在片尾跟同学们公布之外，到时候也可以谈谈跟今天题目相关的冠带的文法概念哦。好，那我们就不浪费时间，准备开始啦。 Here we go。
Contaminate. Contaminate.
动词污染。
Once contaminated, our hands can transfer virus to the eyes, nose or mouth.
双手一旦受到污染，就会把细菌传递到眼睛、鼻子或嘴巴。
Once contaminated, our hands can transfer virus to the eyes, nose or mouth.
Seed.
Seed 名词种子，动词播种。
Most farmers need loans to buy seeds for the next year's crops.
大部分农夫需要贷款购买种子才能耕种隔年的作物。
Most farmers need loans to buy seeds for the next year's crops.
Enormous. Enormous.
形容词，巨大的，庞大的。
An enormous python was seen eating a dog.
有人看见一只巨大的蟒蛇吃掉了一只狗。
An enormous python was seen eating a dog.
Ground. Ground.
名词，地面，土地。
The cat just lay on the ground, waiting to be fed.
那只猫就躺卧在地上，等着被喂食。
The cat just lay on the ground, waiting to be fed.
Persist. Persist.
动词，坚持，持续。
Why do you persist in writing these oppositions?
你为什么要坚持写这些反对的言辞呢？
Why do you persist in writing these oppositions?
Dirt. Dirt.
名词，尘土、泥土、脏污。
The only evidence left at the crime scene was the dirt on the living room floor.
犯罪现场唯一留下的证据就是客厅内的尘土。
The only evidence left at the crime scene was the dirt on the living room floor.
Harvest.
Harvest. 名词动词，收割，收获。
It suggested that passion fruit be harvested fully ripe for the best flavor.
建议百香果完全熟透了再收割，才能有最棒的风味。
It suggested that passion fruit be harvested fully ripe for the best flavor.
Environmental. Environmental.
形容词，环境的，环保的。
The non-profit environmental organization received $2 million in donation.
那个无盈利环保组织收到200万的捐助。
The non-profit environmental organization received $2 million in donation.
Destruction. Destruction.
名词，毁灭，破坏。
The typhoon led to the destruction of all their crops.
那次台风把他们所有的作物都破坏殆尽。
The typhoon led to the destruction of all their crops.
Grain. grain 名词谷物颗粒
Our cows are put on grain diet for 2 weeks before slaughter
我们的牛在屠宰前会喂食两周的谷物
Our cows are put on grain diet for 2 weeks before slaughter
Fertile 形容词肥沃的
Our good quality fruit results from the fertile soil in ideal weather conditions.
土壤肥沃气候合宜我们才能产出那么高品质的水果
Our good quality fruit results from the fertile soil in ideal weather conditions.
Increase.名词、动词，增加、增长、增大。
Travel increases one's knowledge of the world.
旅游增加了人们对世界的了解。
Travel increases one's knowledge of the world.
Cultivation. 名词，耕种、栽培。
The entire cultivation of the grapes will be used to produce red wine.
这里全部栽种的葡萄都会拿来制作红酒。
The entire cultivation of the grapes will be used to produce red wine.
Grow. 动词，成长、增长、种植。
Tomatoes can be easily grown outside in a sunny spot.
番茄在户外阳光充足的地方很容易就种得起来。
Tomatoes can be easily grown outside in a sunny spot.
Scarce. 形容词，稀有的，稀缺的。
Clean water is a scarce resource, especially in this region.
干净的水源在这个地区尤其稀缺。
Clean water is a scarce resource, especially in this region.
Produce. 名词，农产品。
The small town is known for its dairy produce.
这个小镇因生产乳制农产品而闻名。
The small town is known for its dairy produce.
Agriculture. 名词，农业。
Agriculture in most countries depends on government subsidies.
多数国家的农业都仰赖政府的补贴。
Agriculture in most countries depends on government subsidies.
Seasonal. 形容词，季节的。
All entrees are served with a mixture of seasonal vegetables.
所有的主菜都搭配综合季节时蔬。
All entrees are served with a mixture of seasonal vegetables.
Indigenous. 形容词，本土的，土著的。
The indigenous people have lived on the island for a long time.
土著人民在岛上生活了很长的时间。
The indigenous people have lived on the island for a long time.
Plant.动词种植栽种名词植物工厂
Doris planted a lot of roses in the garden.
Doris 在花园里种了很多玫瑰花
Doris planted a lot of roses in the garden.
Overflow. 动词溢出泛滥
The week-long downpour caused the lake to overflow its banks.
持续一周的暴雨使得湖水溢出岸边。
The week-long downpour caused the lake to overflow its banks.
Crop. Crop. 名词，作物，庄稼。
Corn is one of the most widely distributed food crops.
玉米是全球分布最广泛的食用作物之一。
Corn is one of the most widely distributed food crops.
Arable. Arable. 形容词，可耕作的。
Most of the world's unused arable land is in Africa.
全世界大部分未开垦的耕地都在非洲。
Most of the world's unused arable land is in Africa.
Float. Float. 动词漂浮。
I don't know how to swim and probably can't float.
我不会游泳，可能连漂都漂不起来。
I don't know how to swim and probably can't float.
Ample. Ample.形容词，充足的，充裕的。
The daycare center left her ample time to work on the project.
有了日间照护中心，她就有充裕的时间可以做企划案。
The daycare center left her ample time to work on the project.
Tent. Tent. 动词，照顾，照料。
My grandparents get up early in the morning every day to tend the plants.
我爷爷奶奶每天都早起照料那些植物。
My grandparents get up early in the morning every day to tend the plants.
Harmful. Harmful. 形容词，有害的。
The detergent is proved to be harmful to the environment.
这种洗洁剂已经证实是对环境有害的。
The detergent is proved to be harmful to the environment.
Perspire. Perspire. 动词，出汗，流汗。
Hot and perspiring, he toiled up the dusty ascent.
他艰难地在尘土飞扬的坡道上爬着，热得汗水淋漓。
Hot and perspiring, he toiled up the dusty ascent.
Flock. Flock. 名词，一群。
While we were taking photos, we saw a flock of seagulls flying overhead.
我们拍照时看到一群海鸥从头顶飞过。
While we were taking photos, we saw a flock of seagulls flying overhead.
Irrigation. Irrigation. 名词，灌溉。
Irrigation is needed to make crops grow in arid areas.
要使庄稼在干旱地区生长，就一定需要灌溉。
Irrigation is needed to make crops grow in arid areas.
Yeah, 复习完影片的单字过后又来到片尾解题的环节啦。还记得一开始给同学们一个文法的测验题吗？要如果忘了的话，进画面。再给你三秒钟的时间作答哦。三、二、一，选好了吗？好，那我们就开始正式解题啦。很显然这一题的四个选项都是不同的关代码。那现在同学们要如果还不熟悉关代有哪些，要怎么做分类的话，可以点选右上角的标签页，回顾我上一支影片的解题环节哦。那我们就继续往下走。上集影片提到关代的选择有两个方向要看。第一，空格往前追，找到先行词，能够让我们断定这个关代的属性，意思也就是能够让我们知道到底要用人的关代还是事物的关代。再来第二，空格往后追，看好子句里面的范围，我们就能够断定这个关代的格位。上期影片提到的大原则是缺什么补什么嘛，意思也就是 子句里面缺了主词就要补主格冠带，缺了受词就要补受格冠带。那我们带这个概念回到今天的题目当中，我们可以先从空格往前追，发现先行词是 the Mexican artist， 意思是墨西哥的艺术家，那算是个人，我们就定好冠带的属性是人。那就此呢，我们可以先把 B 选项的 which 表示物的冠带给删除。我们接着可以从空格往后追，看好子句里面的范围，发现有个主词的 sculptures， 意思是雕塑，而动词是 be 动词的 are， 那 be 动词的后方呢是不会再有其他受词的，那就奇怪了。我们现在发现子句里面的范围有个主词，但又不缺受词，跟我们上期影片提到的概念无关啊，那该怎么办呢？那就来到这一题的核心文法观念了，同学们就请记好。我们在判断一个冠带的格位的时候，要如果发现子句的范围里面既不缺主词又不缺受词的话，我们就可以观察这个空格是不是前后各有一个名词。要如果有的话，我们就可以试着在这空格里面塞入一个中文的的，去解读一下语义，那就看看语义能不能够被解读为名词一的名词二。要如果这个语义解读得通的话，那就代表空格前后这两个名词它们是有个所有关系的，我们就可以借此塞一个所有格的冠带 whose 进来。那带着这个冠带选择的概念，我们再回到题目当中，我们可以看到空格的前方有个名词的 artist， 意思是艺术家，而空格的后方也有一个名词 sculptures， 意思是雕塑。那在子句里面既不缺主词又不缺受词的情况下，我们可以试着塞一个中文的的进来，把语义解读为是艺术家的雕塑。那这个语义要如果解读得通的话，就代表这空格前后的两个名词它们是有成一个所有关系，借此我们应该要把答案认定为是个所有格的 whose 才对。那因此我们可以把错误的 ABC 三个选项给删除，再把正确答案的猪选项套入句子当中，我们整句解读过一遍。句首大写， The Mexican artist whose sculptures are on display at the museum is expected to deliver a speech on Friday， 意思是其雕塑在博物馆展出的那位墨西哥艺术家预计会在周五演讲，语义如此。好，今天的解题到此就算结束。解题环节过后，依照惯例要给同学们三题跟我们刚刚提到冠带选择相关的文法题目，要给同学们烧脑啦。再请同学们把你觉得正确的答案留在下方的留言栏目，我会再去帮同学们检查啦。最后要如果喜欢我的影片的话，请帮我按赞加分享，又或者想听我谈谈什么其他跟英语学习相关的主题，也请在下方留言栏目让我知道啦。好，这一期影片到此就算差不多啦，我是 Parker， 这是帕格英文，我们下期影片再见啦，拜。